today, Jonathan visits the National Aquarium in Baltimore to learn about the job of a dive safety officer. Welcome to Jonathan Bird's Blue World.
It's November, and cameraman Bill and I are on a road trip, driving from New England down to Baltimore, Maryland.
Cameraman Bill's driving!
Baltimore might not be the first place you would expect an episode of Blue World, but we're here to meet an old friend at the National Aquarium in the heart of the Waterfront District. We pull up bright and early and head over to the entrance. The waterfall is an impressive first sight inside the foyer, with its pool filled with salmon. The glass walls of this impressive facility afford a gorgeous view of the city and harbor. The National Aquarium has a number of large marine exhibits, like the Blacktip Reef exhibit, looking like a coral lagoon underneath the skeleton of a finback whale. Shark Alley contains several species of sharks and sawfish. There is a fantastic touch tank area where guests can touch skates, horseshoe crabs, and even jellyfish. Public relations manager Lauren Hartman is taking me down to the diving area to find Holly.
Holly!
Jonathan!
So good to see you.
Great to see you.
Welcome to the National Aquarium.
Thank you.
You're just in time for our dive briefing.
Oh, awesome. Let's go.
Come on in.
Holly and I have been friends for more than 20 years, and she's the dive safety officer here at the National Aquarium.
So a lot of these are just trending ones. Zeke, zebra shark, is still in Q pool, okay? He's off exhibit for timeout. Lady Ray.
Today, Holly is giving the morning dive briefing to the volunteer divers who will be cleaning the exhibits and feeding the fish.
I was helped with that move. Her tail is healing actually really nicely. We got to look at it the other day, okay? The crooked jaw hogfish.
As the DSO, dive safety officer, for the aquarium, Holly has a lot of responsibility.
So, Holly, tell me about your job. What does a DSO do at an aquarium?
Okay, so the general theme is manage dive safety operations for all, whether it's on-site, like aquarium exhibit diving, or off-site, which we consider field diving. So it's safety, equipment, training, it's putting on the manager hat. Here, we interface with the husbandry team as far as how they work with our volunteer divers, because the volunteer divers help feed and clean the exhibit. Probably our biggest customer is probably husbandry, but we work with media relations folks. We'll work with philanthropy for VIP dives. We have a guest immersion program that we share that project with an outside dive shop, which works really well for us here. You're a manager, you're a trainer, you're a dive buddy.
But ultimately, DSO, dive safety officer.
How many, risk manager.
How many divers are you managing the safety of here?
Over 200.
200 divers?
We have alone, yeah, over 150 volunteer divers, soon to grow next year with an additional recruits. We have probably one of the larger volunteer diver groups in the country of for aquariums.
Great. Awesome.
Cool.
Well, let's go diving.
Let's go.
It's always a little bit weird, but really exciting to be putting your gear together in a hallway. Like, I'm not out on a boat. I'm in a building.
Cameraman Bill and I will be joining Holly on a dive in the Atlantic Coral Reef exhibit as she does her daily inspection.
You guys are already up at level four.
This exhibit is a ring-shaped tank containing over 1,000 fish.
So where we're going to enter today is this platform. The exhibit is 13 feet deep. It always, to me, seems a lot deeper because when you walk it, it just seems, you know, you've got several layers. And this spirals down to the Shark Alley exhibit. and then it spirals down to underwater viewing for black tip reef. It's a really cool system. It's sort of stacked.
We suit up on the dive platform. Next, we drop into the warm 75 degree water. Talk about convenient diving. As I descend, the early morning vacuuming team is just finishing up, pulling their hoses out of the water. Holly will lead me and Bill around the exhibit. The entire inner wall of the exhibit is glass. The fish can see out just as well as the people can see in. A bonnethead shark catches my eye. This little guy is like a mini hammerhead. A bit shy around our lights, but still curious. On the gravel bottom, a stingray. And flying overhead, a cow-nosed ray. These animals are fed every day by divers, so they're not shy at all. A pair of porcupine fish are a type of puffer. They can inflate to the size of a basketball if threatened, but they rarely need to do that in here. Some of the fish are so friendly that they come too close, blocking your view. This hogfish wants some camera time until he's cut off by an angelfish. As Holly makes her way around the giant ring-shaped tank, I follow behind, amazed by the size of it. With 335,000 gallons, this exhibit has as much water as about 25 swimming pools. Holly's looking in every crack and hole because she's trying to find one of the moray eels, which has been hiding for a few days. The two morays, known as Oscar and Felix, are known to vanish for days at a time. The reef structure in the exhibit, while it's not living coral, provides the same kind of habitat for the fish that a living reef would. And as well, it has interesting features for divers, including a great swim through, which makes it feel like an underwater playground. As we near the end of the dive, Felix is nowhere to be found, but the tarpon wants some camera time. Soon our inspection is over and we have to leave the best dive in Baltimore. Clear and warm with no current. Getting to dive here is great fun. And I learned that you can start out as a volunteer, and maybe if you stick with it long enough, you could work your way up to DSO.